Assalamu alaikum dear students, I hope you all are doing good. Today we will starting our new chapter, but before starting a new chapter we will recite a dua. So repeat with me, Rabbi zidni ilma, Rabbi zidni ilma, ay mere Rab, mere ilm mein izafa farma. So today we have a chapter is word processing. In this chapter we will learn about different function of word. So the first function that we are discussing here, that is superscript and subscript. And how can we perform is, look at the desktop screen. Now here we have the word afaq. We can turn this alphabet into superscript and subscript. Firstly, we will change into subscript. How can we do it? Firstly, we will select the text which we have to turn into superscript. Then we select the home button. In the home button, here we have the option is superscript. With the help of this option, we can click on it, then you can see our text turn into superscript. Then we have the subscript. How can we do it? Same like this. Firstly, we select the text. Then we change into subscript. We will move on the home tab. In the home tab, here we have the option here, the subscript. We click on it. Now you can see our text change into subscript. In this way, we can change our text into superscript and subscript. Now I will repeat the same function. What we have done for superscript, we click on the home tab. In the home tab, we have the option of superscript. We click on it, our text turn into superscript. Same as if we want to change our text into subscript, we select our text, then we move on the home tab. Here we have the subscript option. We click on it, then you can see our text change into subscript. Now we will move on the second function, that is alignment. So now we will discuss about the alignment. Basically, text alignment is the manner in which text is placed between margin on a page. There are four types of alignment. Number one is align left, two is align right, three is center, and the fourth is justified. How can we use this alignment? To use this alignment, firstly we will select our text, click the home tab. You can see these four options are available in the paragraph group. In the paragraph group, we have the align left, align right, center and justify. With the help of all these buttons, we can change the position of our text. How can we do it? Firstly, you can see the text. Firstly, I will select this text. Then I will click the align left. When we click on it, you can see our text position is changed. If we want that my text position change into right side, how can we do it? In the paragraph group, here we have the option is align right. When we click on it, you can see my text position is changed. If we want that your text will be in center, here we have the option center. You can click on it, you can see your text position is changed. Then we have the justify option. When you click on it, you can see your text position is changed. Same as all these keys have some short keys. Align left short key is Control plus L. When you click Control plus L, the same function performed in your screen. Then aligned right short key is Control plus R. Then you can see your text position is changed. Center key ka jo short key hai, that is Control E, and the justify key की जो शॉर्ट की है दैट इज कंट्रोल जे. दीज ऑल आर द शॉर्ट कीज. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस शॉर्ट की यू कैन चेंज द पोजिशन ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट ईजली. So now we will discuss about the border and shading effect. Basically, border and shading effect are used to enhance the appearance of text. You can apply border and shading effect to it. Follow the step giving below to apply shading. The first step for applying shading is, firstly you have to select the text like this. Then we will move on the home tab. Here we have the paragraph group. Click on the arrow of the shading button. This is the arrow of the shading button. You can click on it. Then you have to select any color you want like this. Now you can see your text appearance is changed. Then we have how to apply borders. So now we are discussing that how to apply borders. Firstly, we will select the text like this. Move on the home tab. In the home tab, here we have the option is paragraph group. In the paragraph group, here we have the option is border. When we click on it, here we have the option is border and shading. Now, I can select any border, like I will select this one and then apply OK button. Now you can see my text appearance is changed. So in this way we can change the appearance of our text. So now in this chapter we have learned about the superscript and subscript and how can we perform it. Then we learn about the different types of alignment. Basically four type of alignments we have: left, right, center and justify. And we also learn how can we apply these alignments. Then we have learned about the borders and shading effect and how can we apply it on Windows screen. So here we stop our chapter. We will continue our video with next new topic. Thank you.